हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ श्वेता बंडे एंड माय प्रोजेक्ट पार्टनर्स आर ओमकार पाटिल, कौस्तुभ वांगणकर एंड यश पाटने. वी आर स्टडिंग इन घरडा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी लवेल. वी आर हियर टू गिव सम इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट अवर प्रोजेक्ट. अवर प्रोजेक्ट टाइटल इज डेवलपमेंट ऑफ जियोपॉलीमर कॉन्क्रीट बाय यूजिंग डिफरेंट इंग्रेडिएंट्स एट एम्बियंट टेम्परेचर, डन अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ प्रोफेसर एस एस पाटिल. जियोपॉलीमर कॉन्क्रीट इज एन इनोवेटिव construction material which shall be produced by the chemical action of inorganic molecules. Fly ash is a byproduct of coal obtained from the thermal power plant. It is an excellent alternative construction material to the existing plain cement concrete. Geopolymer concrete shall be produced without using any amount of ordinary Portland cement. To produce environmental friendly concrete, we have to replace the cement with some binder. We should not create any bad effect on environment. The use of industrial byproduct as a binder can reduce the problem. In this respect, the new technology geopolymer concrete is a promising technique. The objective of our project is study different ingredient of geopolymer concrete to develop geopolymer concrete by using different waste materials like fly ash, GGBS, etc. To compare mechanical properties of different mixed design of geopolymer concrete. To conclude with best suitable proportion of ingredient of geopolymer. Material we used are fly ash, GGBS, coarse aggregate, fine aggregate, alkaline solutions. Fly ash is an aluminum silicate source material used for synthesis of geopolymeric binder. Fly ash is gathered from coal fire power stations all over the world for use in concrete mixes. GGBS, ground granulated blast furnace slag, is another byproduct of industry commonly used in OPC concrete mix design. It is generally used for to lower the heat of hydration, resist abrasion wearing from groundwater. Coarse and fine aggregate. Coarse and fine aggregate tested conforms to specification as per 383/1970 with a fine aggregate belonging to zone 2 as per the specification. Alkaline solution. Sodium silicate gel Na2SiO3 and sodium hydroxide NaOH solution used for fly ash activation. Sodium hydroxide solution of 8, 12 and 14 molar was prepared by mixing the pellets with water. The mass of NaOH is depend upon solution varied depending upon the concentration of solution expressed in terms of molar M. In the present experimental work, properties of material used in experimental work were determined. Then fly ash and GGBS based geopolymer concrete M40 cubes and conventional concrete M40 cubes of size 150 mm by 150 mm by 150 mm were cast. After the completion of curing period, weight of both conventional and geopolymer concrete cubes will be taken with water to binder ratio is 0.4 to 0.5. The acidic solution containing NaOH and Na2SiO3 were prepared separately. The cubes were demolded after 36 hours of casting. The cube of geopolymer concrete were kept for curing under the ambient curing at laboratory temperature 27 plus or minus 2 degrees Celsius for 7 days. Compressive strength test will be carried out using IS 516-1959 codebook at the end of curing period, that is 1 day, 3 days, 7 days for geopolymer concrete and for the period of 28 days for conventional concrete cubes. Compressive strength test will be conducted. The cube specimen shall be tested for compressive strength under the UTM. Test result for the fully replacing cement are 50% of fly ash and 50% of GGBS. The compressive strength is 5.4 and 90% of fly ash and 10% of GGBS. The compressive strength is 1.57 Newton per mm square. It is observed that compressive strength decreases as percentage of fly ash increases. Test results for the partially replacing cement. Percentage of fly ash is 50% and 50% of percentage is cement. Compressive strength is 14.5. 80% of fly ash and 20% of cement. The compressive strength is 5.3 newton per mm square. It is also observed that compressive strength decreases with increase in percentage of fly ash. The conclusion of our project is, by effective utilization of waste material like fly ash and GGBS, the strength and durability aspect can reduce air pollution by converting this pollution-causing particulate matter into useful building material. With utilization of waste material, the environmental pollution and disposal of waste can be effectively reduced and paves new path for innovative construction material and techniques. The scope is, geopolymer cement is an innovative material and real alternative to conventional Portland cement for use of transportation in infrastructure, construction and offshore application. Thank you.